Blossom the panda was wandering through a forest of bamboo, looking for a tasty snack. It was autumn, and the days were getting shorter. Blossom's tummy rumbled. Where could she find food? Ever cheerful, Blossom didn't give up hope. Instead, by the light of the rising full moon, she headed toward town. Soon, wonderful smells wafted about her. Blossom followed her nose to an ornate wooden gate. With a squirm and a squeeze, Blossom managed to crawl under the gate. She was amazed by what she saw on the other side. The town was decorated for the moon festival. Colorful lanterns lit up the night sky, and a giant dragon shimmied and shook down the street. Best of all, there were banquet tables covered with food for as far as the eye could see. Blossom couldn't believe her good fortune. But before Blossom could begin her feast, someone suddenly shouted, "A bear!" "A bear? Where?" thought a frightened Blossom as she dashed into the crowd. Blossom darted between guests and ducked beneath the parading dragon to hide. While she was under the dragon, the little panda couldn't help but shimmy and shake along. That is, until her fellow dancers spotted her. As Blossom scurried back toward the feast, she saw a beautiful girl at a banquet table. It was Mulan. Mulan loved the moon festival. Her favorite part of the gathering was eating mooncakes, and there was a mountain of them right in front of her. But just as Mulan reached for a mooncake, the tower of cakes collapsed. Mulan was puzzled. What had made the mooncakes topple? As she leaned over the table, she discovered the answer. Sitting in a pile of mooncakes was the cutest little panda she had ever seen. Blossom had pulled a cake from the bottom of the pile, causing the rest to tumble to the ground. Mulan lifted Blossom up into the night sky and invited her not only to join the feast, but to come live with her too. At the end of the festival, Mulan made a wish and released a glowing lantern into the sky. As Blossom watched the lantern float away, she made a wish too. And it came true. Nowadays, Blossom is never far from Mulan or a snack. It was market day, Mulan's favorite day of the week. She was going to gather ingredients for a special meal. "Blossom, be a good panda while I'm gone," Mulan said. "You behave too, Mushu. I'll see you at home for dinner. And no wandering off." Blossom watched as Mulan disappeared around a bend. She thought about all the wonderful market day food, and her tummy grumbled. Mushu's tummy grumbled too. "Let's go," they both shouted. Cricky squeaked his concern, but when they wouldn't listen, he decided to join the fun. Being at the market was exciting. Stalls were stacked high with piles of fruits and vegetables. Buckets of bouquets spilled out onto the streets. Blossom and Mushu bounded along, while Cricky tried to keep up. Everything looked delicious. Blossom plucked a pomelo, while Mushu picked dragon fruit. And Cricky grabbed green long beans. The friends sampled lemons. They were a little sour. The friends sampled peppers. They were so spicy. Blossom just had to drink some water. When she spotted a fountain, she dashed for it. The water was cool and soothing. Then Mushu spied Mulan. She was headed right toward them.
Blossom, Cricky, quick, hide!
He half whispered, half shrieked. Blossom had to think fast and hide in plain sight.
Phew!
That was close. Blossom's tummy was really grumbling now, and there was only one thing she wanted. Sweet cake. But by the time Blossom arrived at the stall, the last cake was gone. Just then, Mushu and Cricky found Blossom.
I'm ready to go home, she sighed.
Cricky began to jump and squeak.
Go home. Home. They needed to get back before Mulan.
You're right. Let's go, Blossom shouted. Home was filled with wonderful smells, and that could only mean one thing.
Uh-oh, Blossom whispered. Mulan beat us here.
Now they were in real trouble.
Or were they? Time for dinner, announced Mulan.
To their surprise, the table was filled with delicious dishes. Next to the rice, Blossom saw the very last sweet cake. After a long day and with her belly full, Blossom says goodnight to her princess and dreams of the next market day.